So the term desirable difficulties is a term I came up with over 20 years ago now. And at that time, I was very impressed with various kinds of experimental phenomena that sort of indicated that something that posed challenges for people, made them uncomfortable even, and seemed to be slowing down the rate of learning, then actually enhanced long-term learning and memory. So the notion is they're desirable because they enhance the very target of training and instruction, long-term retention, transfer of knowledge. They're difficulties because they pose challenges for the learner. And among those difficulties are spacing repeated study opportunities rather than massing them, introducing variation in the conditions of learning rather than keeping the conditions constant and predictable, interleaving the separate things that are to be learned rather than blocking practice, which is something everybody does in real-world settings, and things like feedback, so providing only intermittent feedback rather than constant feedback. All of those things share the same sort of pattern, which is when you contrast those difficulties with often what people actually do, you see the pattern that it appears that people are making slower progress during the acquisition phase. But then when you measure performance at a delay, there's an enhancement. Often, people sometimes think it's a matter of making something difficult has positive effects all by itself. It's not really that. The difficulties, basically the word desirable is important. A difficulty can be desirable for one person at their present state of knowledge because they're able to respond to it. Whereas another person would not, as of yet anyway, have the background knowledge to respond to it adequately. So something called a generation effect is a very good illustration of that. There's decades of research showing that if I, as a teacher or instructor, could get a student to generate an answer rather than my giving it to them, they'll remember it much better later on. But they have to be able to generate it by virtue of what they know already and the cues an instructor would give them. They have to succeed at the generation. So a problem can be that without an adequate background, you can't succeed at the generation. And at that point, it's not a desirable difficulty, it's an undesirable difficulty. So for example, in the domain of motor skills, a couple colleagues, Tim Lee and Mark Guadagnoli, have done research which focuses on what they call the challenge point. This is the kind of thing that's right at the right point, given the preparation a learner has, to be the optimal difficulty or optimal challenge. And I'm emphasizing that because sometimes the term has become popular and sometimes people portray it as, if I just make things hard on somebody, they'll learn better. And it's not that so much. It's that these selective difficulties induce the very processes that create long-term retention and understanding.